Adele, do you want to know something cool? From you? What? I have managed to deduce that students have a weird obsession with 2B pencils. You know what? I think so too. Because up next, we have Eric here with the topic. You guessed it, life is like a box of 2B pencils.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Can everyone hear me loud and clear? Okay, let's start. Honorable judges, accurate timekeeper, and the wonderful MCs have managed to come up with another statement for an opening. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, to me, life is amazing. This can compare to anything. I could talk to you today about how life is a piece of chewing gum on the sidewalk, because it's always getting stepped on. I could tell you today that life is like a trolley, because it's always been pushed around. But ultimately, to me today, I'm going to look at life in a different perspective. I'm going to tell you why life is like a box of human senses. To me, the box is life itself. It symbolizes life. And the pencils are the cuts we take in life. A wise man once said, the person you are today is never the same as the person you are yesterday. You change so much throughout the day that sometimes the person you are today is irrecognizable from the person you are in the past. In the same way, I open a box of cookie pencils, I pick my pencil, I pick my path by natural instinct. Sometimes I don't really know what's going to happen on that path, but I pick it anyway. In the same way, in life, sometimes you pick your paths by natural instinct. Okay? But as you go on, you realize that the pencil of yours, it kind of evolves. I have itchy fingers, I like to scrape the paint off my pencil. Okay, I like to chew the end of my pencil. Yes, I know it's disgusting. But as it goes on, my pencil changes. The pencil I use right now is not the same as any of the other pencils in that box. It's different, and I see from there that my path has branched out. It's different now. And that is why, in a sense, life can be compared to a pencil. But ultimately, you have to realize, at the end of the day, we're going to throw away that pencil and we're going to pick a new path. An entirely different path. As the wise man once said, the person you are today is not the person you are yesterday. So this brings me to my second point. As you're writing, two things are bound to happen. First of all, your pencil might break by accident, on purpose. Depends on the kind of person you are. Or your pencil become blunt. So in this case, I deduce that there are three things any sane person would do. You could sharpen the pencil, you could throw away the pencil, pick a new pencil, or you could just give up and say, tell you what, I'm just going to stop writing. It's up to you. So in the same way in life, what happens when you encounter a difficulty on that path? In other words, as you're using the pencil and something bad happens, what do? Do you give up on life as it is, throw away the pencil and say, I'm not going to do it anymore? Or are you going to pick a new pencil? Are you going to pick a new path? Go turn over a new leaf, become someone new. Or are you going to sharpen the pencil? Are you going to become a better person? Make what's left of the pencil, what's left of the path. Are you going to do that? So these are things and how life can be compared to the pencil. But ultimately, let's take a look at sharpening the pencil. Okay, inside life, I can't speak for the pencil itself. I can imagine it must be quite painful for a pencil to be sharpened. It's a very traumatizing experience. It's spinning around in circles as parts of your body are taken off. But in the same way in life, as you encounter a difficulty and you want to pick yourself up, it's not easy. It's just as traumatizing for the pencil as it is for you. It takes a bit of effort to pick yourself up. And sometimes you don't have the sharpener. The sharpener is in someone else. You need to borrow the sharpener. Sometimes you can't pick yourself up by your own means. You need someone else to help you. In that way, life is kind of like a box of 2B pencils. Moving on to my third point. Now, ultimately, why do you buy a box of 2B pencils? Now, I have to tell you, and I'm sure you're sorry to break it to any of you who are doing this, you don't buy a box of 2B pencils to put it on a pedestal and stare at the box. You buy a box of 2B pencils because of what's inside of you. In life, it's the same. People may like you for what you are on the outside, but what really matters is what you are on the inside. Because ultimately, what you are on the outside is not going to make much of an impact. What you are on the inside is going to make an impact. It's not the box that makes the difference. It's the pencils inside and the writings you do with those pencils that make the difference. So ladies, I have to tell you, I may not be much on the outside, but inside I'm very nice. That your pencils are going to end, they're going to get short, you're going to throw them away. Okay? All the pencil sharpenings are going to gather at the side there, you're not going to have no pencils. Your box is going to become useless, harboring nothing. Ultimately, this is the end of the road. But
rather than comparing life with any other thing, I realized that a box of Tui pencils is different. Because ultimately, what you do with the pencils is what you leave behind. All those writings you did, all those drawings you did, whether it's scribbling on your friend's face while sleeping in class, giving your teacher an essay you wrote by pencil, those are things you leave behind. Whether it's writing, "I love Versace" on a web wall, that's what you leave behind. And the same way in life, it's not our body that we leave behind, it's our legacy. The things we do, those are the things that matters, what we leave behind. In a way, it is comparable to the Tui box or Tui pencils. So my message for you today is very simple. Use your box or Tui pencils wisely. Because I had to bring in a quote from my father. When he was young, he handed me a box of Tui pencils. Being a thrifty person he is, he said, "Son, remember, you're only going to get one box of Tui pencils, you better use it wisely." I think the same applies to everyone here. Use your life wisely. Thank you.
Thank you, Aaron. The time taken was 5 minutes and 12 seconds.